When I start to talk about food and I talk about politics, people tend to get sort of their back up, that I immediately go from talking about the emotionality about food to politics, mm-hmm. And to sort of larger issues. What is your last page of the book?
Well, I just really was interested, like the longer that I spent doing, you know, this work, the more that I just felt, I was like, food isn't really the problem here, right? Like, people actually like and enjoy good food when they have access to it. It's not, right, like my coworker at Walmart was eating crappy food because it was cheap and it was easy, not because he was like, oh, a really healthy casserole, I would never eat that because it's disgusting, right? It's not easy to get. And if people aren't familiar with that kind of food, you know, they won't eat it. But, you know, something that I find over and over again, right, you can get anyone to talk to you about, like, food, right? I mean, you know this. And, right, and they... like, people will eat good, fresh, healthy food if it's given to them, and it's easy, and it's something that feels accessible to them. And that's something that doesn't just happen because we say, oh, we should really respect the farmer and the land and the environment, which we should, right? But it's because they can afford it, and they have a life that gives them time and space to do that, you know? I mean, people work so, like, people at the high income level, like, work so much. People in low income parts of the economy work a lot. Like, welfare reform really pushed a lot of people into working very hard at the low end of the economic spectrum. And that makes it really hard, right, to do cooking. And so we've got to have a conversation about food that isn't just about what's in the shopping cart or on our plate, but about the shape of the life that we're building for Americans, right? Because if wages are stagnating and people have less and less time at home and everyone's stressing the heck out because they have insurance premiums that are insane, all of that makes it really hard for people to take care of their diet in a really good way. And we really pay a big public price, right, for having an unhealthy population. So there, you know, there's a fiscal and sort of like economic competition argument to be made, as well as something that just like good food is like water, right? Like we don't sit here and say, oh, well, poor people just want dirty water, so we'll just let them have dirty water. And if they want to get good, if they want clean water, they can walk 2 miles for it, right? I mean, that we treat healthy food in that way, to me, is increasingly just seems really ridiculous. I mean, almost satirical.